Stand by for words from the commanding officer.
Hello, CFAY. I'm Captain Dave Owen, and welcome to a special edition of Commander's Corner here on 16 August 2012. This is going to be the back-to-school edition. I'm going to have quite a few guests come on from the schools. We got a lot of new administrators. But before I start bringing the guests on, I got some of our announcements to go through here. DUIs. Unfortunately, we have now gone 4 straight weekends with a DUI. We went 70 days with none, and now the last 4 weekends we've gotten one. There's no excuse for this. There's plenty of ways to get around this base. You can probably walk anywhere you want to. There's the designated driver program. There's plenty of taxis. Just a reminder, whenever you take that ignorant oil into your system, don't get behind the wheel of a car, plain and simple. And speaking about the ignorant oil, we had an underage drinker last night. Even though the drinking age here is lower than the states, it's 20, we still had an underage drinker last night. So remember, unless you're 20 years old, you shouldn't be drinking it at all. Don't get into trouble with that. And also keep your hands to yourself. We had a domestic assault last night as well. And that's not a cool thing. And it was a guy and a gal. Guys, what are you thinking? I mean, if you beat a woman up, you're going to get smacked for it. And if you lose, you're going to have to go around knowing that you got beat up by a girl. So don't even get into it, all right? All right, okay. This weekend up at Nagishi is our Bonadori. It'll be running from 3 p.m. to 9 p.m. You can go up there and enjoy the festivities. It's going to be an open base event, probably somewhere between 4,000 to 6,000 people will come on. And you can go up there and learn how to do the bond dancing. The Seco Lieutenant Thornton, Kyoko-san, the OIC, Chief Allen, and his assistant, Reiko-san, will be helping you out up there, and you can learn how to go your hands this way and that way and clap, clap, and all that good stuff. So come on up and do some bond dancing. It'll be good. On the 19th of August, down at the main gate, there's going to be a demonstration. This is part of the normal demonstrations that they do repeatedly. It's going to be from 16:30 to 17:30. The gate's not going to close, but there could be as many as 100 people, 150 people down there protesting our presence here. But as usual, whenever they do it, they show up when they say they're going to, they leave when they say they're going to, and it's always peaceful. But just want you to be aware of that if you see the crowds down at the main gate. On 21 August, we're going to have some entertainment here. They're called the Gym Class Heroes. That will be playing at 1900 at 7 p.m. over in the parking lot by the bowling alley. I've never seen this group before, but I hear they got a couple of hit songs, so if you're into the Gym Class Heroes, they will be here. On the 22nd of August, we've got an open galley for lunch, and the theme for this one is Educator Appreciation Month. So go over to the galley for lunch, pay your $4.55, it's a really good deal, and you can get in there and have the open galley. On 25 August, we got some Captain's Cup stuff going on. You know, we're talking about back to school and everything. Well, it's going to be kickball. Okay, you adults get out there and play kickball. Remember, we're trying to dethrone Subgroup 7, so I don't have to listen to the mouth that can't be ignored, Lauren, bug me anymore about it. All right, they've won it like the last 3-4 years in a row. Let's take them down, please. Okay. Also on the 25th of August, over at the O Club, there's going to be a luau. So you can go over to the luau at the O Club. I guess they're going to have some Tahitian dancers and all that neat stuff. I believe the price is 30 bucks. It's open all hands. So sign up and go over to the luau over at the O Club. After you kick the ball around during the day, you can go do your Hawaiian stuff that night. On the 26th of August, Club A is going to be closed for maintenance. So that's one day you can't go down to Club Alliance. It'll be on the 26th of August for all you Club Alliance goers. And something that's always popular, the NEX Bazaar is coming up in September, 15 and 16. That's always a big event. A lot of vendors come in. We fill up the parking garage over there by Fleet Rec, and you can go buy all sorts of neat stuff. Remind you about energy conservation. It's still hot. It's going to start cooling off before much longer, but we've done great this summer. Remember, don't crank up the ACs. You don't have lights on in rooms when you're not there and things of this nature. Let's be smart. And, of course, one of my favorite topics, the Yokosuka Bay Stars, the minor league team for the Yokohama Bay Stars that play over in Pama. They will be got a couple home games next week, so if you're interested in them, 21st and 22nd, first pitch at 1800 against the Fighters. It's only 1,000 yen to get in, and it's a pretty good deal. I went to the game earlier this week. They actually won 6-5 in a real close one. It was a good game, so that's something else to go do besides head out to the haunch and use your well-spent money on ignorant oil and things like that. All right, I'm going to take a small break here, and we're going to start filtering the guests in as we start talking about the schools. Okay, well, sorry, kids. It's back to school time. And what I got here right now is we're going to go through the different schools. We got a lot of new administrators coming in. We're going to get some information out. And my guests I got right here are representatives from the first school up is the Sullivans. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Thank you, Zach.
New principal at the Sullivans this year, Ms. Dana Chandler. From my understanding, no stranger to Japan, coming down to us from Misawa. So welcome to Yokosuka and taking over the Sullivan Schools.
Thank you, sir.
Familiar face here, though, coming back for his second year is Michael Ochoa.
Thank you, sir.
And he'll be here. And Sullivan's gets a lot of help. They get a second vice principal. We just didn't have enough room on the couch to get everybody in at one time. But her name is Dr. Jacqueline Ferguson, not a stranger, been over at the middle school before she's coming here to us. So going to be well-armed at the middle school and administrators here this year. When's the first day of school for the middle school?
For Sullivan's.
For the Sullivan's, yeah.
First day of school, Monday, August 27th.
Okay, is that for all of them? What about the kindergartners?
Kindergartners is the next week, right after Labor Day, September 4th.
All right, so if you're in kindergarten, you get a little bit of an extra break there. But
unless you're a kindergartner in the multi-age class, which is first in K, and I'm sorry, but they have to start on August 27th.
All right, if a parent wants to find out who's their teacher going to be, how would they do that for the Sullivans?
Well, we're going to post lists at 11 o'clock, between 11 and 11:30 at the BX, and then teachers will be contacting the parents of the students that they have as well, so that you would know by email which teacher your child has, and that'll be all on Friday, August 24th.
Okay, so that'll be on the 24th, so that's good. Anybody wants to know who the teacher's going to be and everything? I always thought it was cool when I went to school. I never knew who the teacher was going to be till I got there. It was always a mystery. Probably because it was a mystery if I was going to show up. I don't know what was going to happen. All right, if someone wants to tour the school, one can get a sneak peek.
A sneak peek?
All right.
Ms. Chapman.
Our sneak peek is August 24th from 12:30 to 1:30.
Okay.
That gives them a chance to get in the school, see their teacher, know where they're going to put their stuff when they get there on Monday morning.
All right. And I understand Sullivan's will be having an open house then sometime in September.
Correct. On September 12th.
Mm-hmm. September 12th. Okay, cool. So anybody who's got students over at the Sullivan's, these are the administrators, and I'm sure we're going to see a lot of them here. And I hope you don't wind up in their office very often, actually. But okay, well, thank you for being here. We're going to move on to our next school here shortly.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you
very much.
Bye. Okay, CFAY, our second school up is Ikego Elementary. So those of you who live in Ikego, this is your new principal and administrator. This is Ms. Valerie Rainey. Thank you, and welcome to Yokosuka.
Thank you. We're excited.
Understand you just came from Turkey.
Yes, Incirlik, Turkey.
Incirlik, Turkey. All right, and you were a fourth grade teacher there?
In Turkey, I taught fourth grade, special education, and fifth grade.
All right, and cool. Well, welcome here. I hope you're getting settled in over the jet lag.
We are. We are. We're settled. We're in a tower out in Ikego, so we're very excited about that.
All right, good. And schools at Ikego start up on the 27th of August.
27th of August is the first day of school. That is for our multi-age, K through 1, as well as our second and third grade.
Okay.
And then our kindergartners come back to school on September 4th.
All right, so that's when Ikego will get started up there. Anybody wants a sneak peek at Ikego, they can do that on the 24th?
We are offering a sneak peek. This is an exciting time for our newcomers, our parents. If you'll come out and visit with us at the school on August 20th, I believe.
Okay.
Check my notes.
Check your notes.
August 20th from 3.
I got sneak peek down here for you on the August 24th.
August 24th.
August 24th on Friday.
August 24th on Friday.
From 2:15 to 3 p.m.
Right, and we will be posting our class lists. We're going to do it a little bit differently this year. Our class lists will be posted in the Ikego Elementary School courtyard. We're not posting our class lists down at the mini mart, which I think has been done in the past.
Okay.
Everybody just drives up to the school anyway. So we're saving a trip.
Cool.
Please just come out to the school and see your class list in the courtyard.
All right, that sounds awesome to me. And if you missed the sneak peek, there's going to be an open house in September.
That's correct.
All right, that'll be on September 11th, and that'll be from 3 p.m. to 4 p.m. So you can come out to the open house. And of course, right now, Ikego, the schools will go from kindergarten through third grade, but here eventually, they've started breaking ground on the new elementary school.
We're very excited. Yes, I've seen the land, so this is not a rumor. It is true.
Yeah, and so that's coming along. I don't have the exact time frame, you know, how things get built here in Japan. Sometimes they get delayed and all that, and but everything's going good there. I'm sure we'll be excited to get more grades there in Ikego.
And yes, that school will actually service. We do right now. We service pre-K through 3,
right.
And the new school will service pre-K through 5. So that will allow families to stay at Ikego longer before they have to be bused into the main base.
Oh, that'd be good. I mean, that cuts down on the kids' wear and tear on the
right.
buses and
That's
things
right.
of that nature. All right, then. Well, again, welcome to Yokosuka.
Thank you.
And I'm sure the kids are looking forward to starting school.
We are, and we're excited for them to come out. We're excited to meet all the new kids, welcome all our returning kids. We are the Fireflies.
Fireflies.
So we really want to glow and be bright this year.
All right. That's your goal. Glow and bright in Ikego.
That's
all
right.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. All right, CFAY, coming all the way from Nagishi, we now have the principal of Bird Elementary. We got Ms. Baxter Oakley. Thank you for coming down to the show today. We got, she was principal last year as well. This is one of our few administrators that isn't changing out this year by the looks of it. And when's the first day of school up in Nagishi?
The first day of school is August 27th for grades 1st through 5th grade, and our kindergarten students start on September 4th.
Okay. Just like the other elementary schools, the kindergartners get to go through Labor Day weekend before they come in.
Yes.
And they start up. If somebody wants to get a sneak peek up at Bird who hasn't been there before, when can they do that?
Our sneak peek will take place on August 24th, Friday, from 1345 to 1430.
Okay, and if someone misses the sneak peek and they want to see the school, I hear you got an open house coming up in September as well?
Yes, our open house is September 18th, and it's from 1700 to 1800.
Okay, how many teachers do you actually have at Bird?
Well, we have 3 classroom teachers, and we have 4 supporting teachers. We have a literacy support specialist, learning impaired teacher. We have a gifted education teacher, our music counselor, and our information center specialist and educational technologist.
Okay, and how many students this time?
So far we have 48 students, but we're hoping for more.
I'm sure it'll be a great school year, and again, thank you very much for coming all the way from Nagishi. You gonna be out doing some bond dancing this weekend up there?
Or? I sure will, so hope to see you there too.
Oh, I'll be there, for the open base event and the Bonadori, so I got to practice. I mean, we'll get it down there.
Okay.
All right. All right. Well, thank you very much,
and
have a great day.
Okay, you too.
Hey, CFAY, we got the Red Devils on the show now. We got the new administrators for Kinnick High School. We got a new principal this year. We've got a new vice principal this year. New principal is Dr. Jennifer Beckwith. Welcome, and thank you for coming to Yokosuka here today. I'm looking at her bio. What a spreadsheet here. This is impressive. I mean, you're coming to us right now from Germany, correct?
That's correct, sir.
Correct, and I see you've been in places like Holland, the UK, Norway, Belgium, Bahrain, New Orleans.
Yes.
And did you like Mardi Gras while you were there?
New Orleans is home for me. So.
Oh, wow, I guess so then.
Yeah.
All right,
so,
absolutely.
Yeah.
I mean, again, former principal positions, former assistant superintendents in Italy and districts and things of that nature.
Sure.
A lot of experience we got coming into the high school here. We're happy to have you, and welcome to Yokosuka.
Thank you very much.
And everybody, just like Batman, needs their Robin. So sitting next to her is, I'm going to try to get this. This is a tongue twister. Miss Emily Lee, okay?
Yes,
Miss Emily Lee.
Got it.
Not a stranger to Japan, coming down to us from up north at Misawa.
Misawa? Mm-hmm.
I can tell you that the snow will melt off a lot sooner down here than it does up there, if you even see any down here. So that's good. Also has experience from Germany and California, and been in Guam and England, so we're getting a lot of good experience in here. The high school, I'm sure, is in good hands right off the bat just by reading this. Now, the high school, the students report back to classes on the 27th, correct?
I think it's the 27th. That I tell you what, I know that it's not this Monday, but it's the following Monday.
Okay, that makes it the 27th.
That's
all right.
It.
We've got
all
it.
Right.
They'll be back there on the 27th.
At 7:15 in the morning.
7:15 in the morning. All right. Hey, you high schoolers, you better start practicing now. You don't want to be show up late to the very first day of class.
I mean,
especially you seniors. This is your senior year. You want to get it kicked off right. And please don't abuse the freshmen too much. I mean, remember when you were a freshman? All right. I mean, they're gonna wander around. They're gonna be a little lost. Don't make them go. Like trying to mop a freezer or anything like that nature. Okay, not that would ever happen. But if you want to get a sneak peek over at the high school, I understand on Friday the 24th there's going to be an opportunity for that.
Absolutely, we're going to do an orientation for our new parents and students, and we're hoping that all of them will come out to get a chance to tour the building, to get a chance to talk with our counselors, to see what's going to happen with their schedules and everything for the new year. So we're looking forward to seeing our new folks. You know,
my understanding is they will find out their schedules and who their teachers are on the first day of school.
Exactly.
Right.
Exactly.
I remember that going to high school not knowing, then they hand out the schedule. I'm like, oh no, I got her again. No, I don't think that's going to happen.
No, it's that's cool.
Or anything of that nature. And then if you missed the sneak peek, I understand in September you're going to have an open house.
Correct. On the 13th of September, we're having an open house beginning at 4:30 in the afternoon to 6:30 in the afternoon, mm-hmm. and that's when we want all of our parents to mm-hmm. come out and be with us and bring your student as well so that you can meet teachers and find out everything about the curriculum, everything that's going to be offered. So we're looking forward to meeting everyone.
All right. I'm sure it's going to be an exciting school year. I mean, I've already seen the Red Devil football team over at Berkey Field getting ready. I'm going to have some of them on the show here a little later on.
Okay. Oh, excellent. And,
they don't know it yet. They're going to help me pick some college predictions for the BCS.
Oh, my goodness.
All right. They'll love
that. Okay.
Yeah, we'll find out. We'll see how good they help me out because I haven't done so well the last 2 years.
Oh, yeah. So who are you rooting for? I mean, who's your big team?
My big team is on probation this year, so I'm not going to talk too much about them.
Oh,
right
wow.
Now.
All righty then.
They're not allowed to participate in the postseason.
Gotcha.
So that kind of messed up my predictions again.
Again. All right. So, yeah. Don't worry. Our boys will help you out.
Our guys will help you. I'm going to count on them. And as far as that note goes, they've already got, they're starting the season off with a big rivalry game on the 24th of August, from what I understand. Mm-hmm. They're going to go up and play the Azama at Itsugi, and I've already had the Itsugi CO sending me emails.
Oh, my. Okay, then.
I'm going to count on them to get us through
That's
there.
That's okay, so. Captain. They're going to come through for you.
All right. I'm always there rooting the Red Devils whenever I can. So,
wonderful.
We'll try to keep going.
We need that. We want that. We need that support from our community, and so happy that you're out there with us.
All right. Again. Well, thanks for coming on the show. And these are your new administrators at the high school, so when you get the note that your kid's down in the principal's office, this is who you're going to see. All right. Okay, well, thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
All right, cool.
Thank you.
Okay, CFAY, we're now going to talk to our last, but definitely not least of our schools, the middle school, and no stranger to Yokosuka, the principal, Mr. Fong. I mean, he's been here so long that one of my administrative assistants used to be one of his students. That's how long Mr. Fong has been around Yokosuka and in this system. So, he's got the middle school running good. Classes starting up on the 27th of August there, like all the other schools.
Just like all the other schools. And our first day, all of our children will have to actually just meet inside the gym, where we'll separate the children out by grade level, and we'll bring them to their respective halls, and then we'll get them into their advisory periods and hand out their schedules. So please, parents, don't worry. Just have your kids come to school and meet in the gym. They shouldn't worry about a thing. And just the Friday previous, we have a newcomers orientation where I'll be addressing the parents and the new kids new to the Yokosuka community, and then we'll take you for a tour of the school so that you won't get freaked out.
So they can get themselves a sneak peek before the school starts.
Exactly.
And everything.
Yeah.
And if they miss that, I understand in September they could come to an open house even.
Exactly. We have a nice open house.
Yeah, the open house for the middle school is scheduled in September, just like all the other ones, and I'm sure it'll be a good time. Theirs is September 12th from 16 to 1800.
Exactly.
And that's 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. for you non-military types. But but otherwise, the middle school, what's your enrollment about these days?
Right now we're about around 550. 500. We went down a little bit from last year, but we're hearing that the numbers will pick up for next year.
Okay, all right, good. So the middle school, a nice facility. Again, a lot of experience in the principal seat over there. And for all you new parents, who's putting students in the middle school for the first time, when you get that call from the middle school, this is who is in the principal's office looking to talk to you. All right.
Right.
So, but again, been around here a long time, and Mr. Fong is our senior principal here. So, again, thank you for coming on the show,
and we look
forward to a very good school year.
And I look forward to working with the military command as well and serving our military communities. Thank you.
All right. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
All right. Okay, with the start of school, that means the sounds of the gridiron is in the air. So I've got with me now some representatives from the Kinnick Red Devil football team. They've been out there practicing. I've seen them all times of the day and night. I think some guys were made to do push-ups last night because of their birthdays when I passed by or something of that nature. But who do I got here today? What's your name?
Alexander Banks.
Alexander Banks, and what do you play?
I play running back and linebacker, sir.
Running back and linebacker. And next to you?
Marcus Boatwright.
And what do you play?
Running back and linebacker. Sorry.
Running back and linebacker. And who's the good-looking guy here on the end?
I'm Dustin Wilson. I play quarterback.
Quarterback, Dustin Wilson. All right. Do you like running the option?
Yes, I do.
You like running the option? Okay. And their first game is coming up. It's going to be a rivalry. They actually got a practice game this Saturday down at Berkey Field starting at 10 o'clock. But then the following week, they go up to Itsugi, and they're going to play Zama. And it's the only game that's going to be played at Itsugi this week. I'm counting on them because the CEO of Itsugi's already been sending me smack emails. I'm hoping they're going to go up there and represent the Red Devils really well. You guys got favorite college football teams?
Georgia.
Georgia? What about you?
I like Ohio State.
You like Ohio State? Good man. But we're not going to the postseason this year. What about you?
Georgia State.
Georgia State. Okay. Well, that means with the high school starting, the college is not far behind, and these experts are going to criticize me right now because, once again this year, I'm going to attempt to pick the 10 teams that are going to go to BCS bowl games. Now, last year I managed to go 4-for-10. The year before I went 3-for-10. We'll see how well I go this year. But, and of course, this is the last year for the BCS bowls because they're going to a playoff system the following year. Okay, but here's my 10 picks to be in BCS bowl games, and when the season's over, you can all tell me how wrong I was. And these guys will start laughing when they start hearing them. Well, USC is no longer on probation and banned from the postseason, and I say the Trojans are moving into the BCS bowl game this year. I'm going to go to the Big 12. I'm going to pick the Oklahoma Sooners. They've been in, they're tied for the most BCS bowl appearances with all the other college teams, so expect Oklahoma in a BCS game. Also from the Pac-12, 14, 16, whatever they are now, I think the Mighty Ducks of Oregon will make a BCS bowl game. Hey, you're going to like this one. I'm picking Georgia from the SEC to be playing on the BCS this year, which means I'm going to pass another SEC team while I'm on the subject, and I'm going to take the Gamecocks out of South Carolina. I'm going against LSU and Alabama. I mean, that's a risky one. They're like number one and two out there right now. But, hey, here's a fact that people don't look at. Even though the SEC has won the title like the last 5-6 years in a row, only one time has that title winner made it to a BCS bowl game the following year. So I'm saying they're not going to do it. All right, this one hurts me. This is the Big Ten. They've had two teams in the BCS the last few years. It seems like forever. I'm going with only one team out of the Big Ten this year because two of their teams cannot go to the postseason. And I'm going with that school from up north, Michigan. That kind of hurts me because I'm a Buckeye, but I'm going with the Wolverines to be in a BCS bowl game. All right, well, these other conferences get to put teams in, so I had to pick some from all of them. The ACC, I'm going to go with Clemson. I'm going to put them into a BCS bowl game. From the Big East, I'm going to go with South Florida. I'm going to say they're going to do it. All right. I don't think they're even ranked yet, but we'll go from there. You'll see a common theme on teams that aren't ranked. I'm going to go back to the the Big 12 or whatever they are. I'm going to take Kansas State. I thought Kansas State got ripped off last year. Kansas State should have been in a BCS bowl game, but so they're going to get redemption this year. That leaves me one BCS bowl buster. Last year, I picked Houston, and they blew it in the very last game of the year. This year, I'm going with Louisiana Tech to be the BCS buster of all of them, and they're probably going to get knocked off the first week against Texas A&M, but I'm still going to go with Louisiana Tech to be the BCS bowl buster. And like I said, these guys are laughing. I only got to get five right to beat last year. All right, so and you can all get on Facebook and make fun of me and remind me come January how wrong I was. But again, Kinnick Red Devils, we look forward to a good season. If you throw a pick six, you're going on calf. That's all there is to it. All right. Okay. Well, thank you for being on the show and good luck to your season, guys.
Yes, sir. You too.
Thank you. All right, CFAY, it's about time to wrap up this version of the Commander's Corner. But naturally, I can't wrap up any video without going to the trivia. From my last video, the TV show I was looking for was Three's Company. And it was answered by Tisha and Rob Tokars. Thank you very much, Tisha and Rob. The sports, it was a two-part question. Only half of it got answered. I was looking for what was the record of a major league team, both in the American League and National League, for most consecutive losses. The American League answer was the Baltimore Orioles from 1988, and I got that answer from Jeremy Latimer. I received no answer on who the National League team is, so that trivia question is still out there. Another trivia question that's still out there was the song I did last week. I got no responses or inputs on what the song was. So here comes again. I'm going to do that same one. Here's the lyrics. You tell me the title of the song and an artist that did it. Yeah, I was always the lazy one, a Southern Californian, but I've got some kinfolk on the Mason-Dixon line. And I'm going to do a second song now, a new song for this week. These lyrics are a little shorter. Same deal, I'll give you the lyrics, you gave me the title of the song and an artist. I got a Letterman sweater with a letter in front for football and track. I got a Letterman sweater with a letter in front for football and track. Okay, what was that one? I'm going to do a movie this time. What film featured the triple Lindy by a man who gets no respect? Not me, I get no respect too, but not me, this man who gets no respect did the triple Lindy in this movie. And another sports question, how many college football bowls are there scheduled for the 2012-2013 season? There's a lot of them. How many are scheduled? I just want to know how many total number, and I don't have to name them or anything. All right, that's all for today, CFAY. You have a safe weekend as usual. Good shipmates don't let shipmates drink and drive. Good shipmates don't let shipmates do drugs. And good shipmates don't let shipmates get sexually assaulted. Have a great weekend, CFAY.